23-year-old Mahesh Kapse woke up in a cold sweat on the morning of June 30th, 2020. Something was not feeling right. He did what many of us often do, check his phone.
Dear users, we are in the process of complying with the Government of India's directive to block 59 apps.
His 1.25 million followers on TikTok that he had just the day before had vanished overnight. Mahesh's skill was to draw people's portraits on demand, making videos of the process and posting it on TikTok. His efforts earned him a handsome 60,000 rupees per month. During lockdown, when his farmer parents were out of work, it was this income that kept the family going. Like him, another 20-year-old Rishikesh Tikone, a daily wager from Pune, earned up to 35,000 rupees a month mimicking lyrics on TikTok. During lockdown, he gained 1.4 million followers and was even featured in a Bhojpuri song.
It was my dream to make a music album that would get thousands of views. It's all wasted now. I feel so lonely.
Stories like these can be heard across India.
Take Dhanraj.
As a farm worker, the most I could make was 150 rupees a day. With these videos, I had started making 35,000. I am back to making 150 now.
Of TikTok's 200 million or 20 crore users in India, an estimated 1.5 to 2 crore regularly created content, of which 5 lakh were professional full-time creators earning tons of money. Influencers from metros and bigger cities made money through brand endorsements, events and workshops, with the top 100 influencers together earning an estimated 120 crore. A top TikToker could charge a brand anywhere between 1.2 to 1.5 lakhs for a story, pic or gif, but the price dropped to 5,000 for those down the rank. Small town influencers of TikTok got by with gifts sent to them by fans and invitations to local functions. TikTok itself earned much less, just 20 to 25 crore in ads in India in the last quarter of 2019, which almost doubled in the next quarter and were expected to earn as much as 200 to 250 crore this year if the ban had not been imposed. Now, TikTok's loss will be the gain of existing established rival platforms like YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and ShareChat. Instagram saw the largest gain among them with 27 lakh, 2.7 million downloads in just a week since the ban, launching Reels made especially for short videos. On the back of nationalism, Indian apps have been given a window of opportunity, some of whom made it to the list of top 20 most downloaded apps on Google Play. But such a host of choices has created confusion. TikTok stars and their followers, not knowing where to migrate, have joined several Indian apps simultaneously. Initially, Mahesh Kapse had just 2 followers on Roposo, down from 12.5 lakh on TikTok, while Dhanraj had 9 as compared to 8.5 lakh earlier. Caught off guard by unexpected surge in downloads, apps like Chingari faced repeated server outages, forcing many Indian apps who had only a small cloud presence to spend large sums of money and scale rapidly in a matter of days. After a week of its entry, Mitro was removed from the Play Store because of rising complaints against its stability. Then it was discovered that Mitro was actually a rebranded version of a $43 off-the-shelf app made by Pakistani developer QBoxers, which was another reason for it being removed.
We don't allow apps that merely provide the same experience as other apps already on Google Play.
Unknown to all but techies, there is a big market for ready-made TikTok clones, with the Bengaluru-based AppScript already having sold their version to 20 people in India.
A good TikTok clone app starts at around $8,000 and goes up as high as $25,000, depending on the features they want, live streaming, social commerce, etc.
When a similar platform is being used by everyone, acquiring users, retaining them and getting them to spend more and more time on the app seems to be crucial in this winner-takes-all market. Well-funded competitors are racing to snap up top-ranking creators of TikTok, who are demanding fees ranging from 3 lakhs to 1 crore for 6-month contracts. Those with lesser funds are trying to build engagement, like Chingari's Talent Hunt, where top creators can earn from a prize pool of 2.8 crore. Roposo is holding 100 online contests with prize money for the best creators and providing them incentives on a daily basis. Trell is adding user engagement features like live talk show hosting and reaction video maker. While venture capital funds, eyeing their next unicorn, are running behind these apps. ShareChat, who already raised 200 million, now has Google interested. Trell closed a $11.4 million round, while Mitro picked up 5 million from Nexus Venture Partners. Some Indian firms are planning to double their teams by the end of the financial year, many of them with former employees of the banned Chinese app, offering salaries of 60 to 70 lakhs plus for mid to senior roles. In a contest of fast, faster, fastest, New York-based app DubSmash has globally accumulated over 100 million downloads, making it a target of acquisition of Facebook and Snap in a deal that may be valued in hundreds of millions of dollars. That price is a steal though, compared with the $11 billion ByteDance was going to raise through an IPO in Hong Kong's Nasdaq. LA-based social video app Triller got 40 million downloads in India and 250 million in all, ranking it number one in all app store categories in 50 markets, including the US, Australia, France, Great Britain and Italy. Even showing promise in the important metric of active users, of which they have 70 million.
We have overtaken YouTube, Instagram, Snapchat and other apps.
Correspondingly, Chingari had 25 million users, but as of mid-August 2020, only 3 million of them were active daily.
Download is not a key metric, rather it is daily active users. The second metric is time spent.
But TikTok is not dead yet. After Trump followed India's lead and banned it in the US, Microsoft in partnership with Walmart and Oracle by itself are looking to buy its US businesses, for which they have been given 45 days to cut a deal. We will build on the experience TikTok users currently love while addressing world-class security, privacy, and digital safety protection. But while TikTok may sell the US business to them, they will likely still control the back-end software and algorithm that made the app so popular and lease it to the new buyer. This may not go down well. TikTok was among 53 of 59 banned Chinese apps which repeatedly accessed users' clipboards where phones and computers temporarily placed data. This violation was happening silently without the user's knowledge, and people only found out because of a new feature in iOS 14 which flags such things. ByteDance's founder and CEO Zhang Yimin tried hard to sidestep the ban by attempting to move their corporate office from China to London. Addicted TikTok users also tried sidestepping the ban, downloading the banned app from the popular Android APK site. In India, TikTok is desperately seeking a meeting with the government but not planning to legally challenge the ban. And although Reliance calls it speculation, TikTok CEO got in touch with India's new digital conglomerate.
Mr. Rambani, would you have any interest in acquiring the app's India unit?
The now banned app has been downloaded 660 million times in the country, a third of all its global downloads. And though loss-making, the India business is likely to be valued at $2.5 to $5 billion or about a tenth of the reported $30 to $50 billion valuation for the entire company. Were TikTok to be acquired by Microsoft or Reliance or someone else, the app may be back in India, upsetting business plans of all TikTok clones and wasting the money poured into developing competitor apps. But pleasing creators like Mahesh Kapse, Rushikesh Tikone and Dhanraj, who lost their bread and butter overnight. Surprisingly, it will also please music labels for whom promoting soundtracks on TikTok was half as expensive as compared to YouTube. By roping in popular creators to use audio clips from their song, music labels would get a 30% bump in views on YouTube and streaming platforms.
A song capable of fetching 20 million hits across platforms is now getting only 2 million after the TikTok ban.
The field is open to all, and everyone is vying for TikTok's crown, even TikTok themselves. Bizbo's limerick. There was a short video app called TikTok, whose banning gave creators a shock. But in came the clones, creating apps for their phones, all vying for the number one spot. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.